De Stockton, California, DJChuyLoco.com.
Por el pues, por aquí estamos, ya ahorita ya abordamos por aquí el barco.
Le renté ese para que se pase en la isla.
Thank you.
ya vamos para arriba, ya vamos al restaurante a comer.
Vamos a traer unos camarones empanizados, claro. Muchachas bonitas, se las cantamos aquí, que le muerda. Y uno, claro.
California. DJ ChuyLoco.com.
Ahora pues por aquí estamos, ya ahorita ya abordamos por aquí el barco. En unos 5 minutos más vamos a salir a la isla. Por aquí estamos. A mañana 20 de septiembre, 51 años de Clara. Vamos a durar 3 días en la isla Catalina por aquí en California. Sí, cómo no.
Están los securities de aquí de la de lo que viene siendo la orilla.
Ahí están las marisqueras. Ahí compras todo el marisco que tú quieras y ahí mismo te lo cocinan. Fish Market. Ahorita va despacito porque vamos a salir apenas lo que viene siendo aquí el puerto. Ya saliendo a mar abierto ya le va a arrancar para llegar allá en 2 horas. Órale pues. Sí, cómo no. Y ahorita ya le están acelerando el motor. Ya vamos a dejar aquí el puerto. Vamos a entrar a lo que viene siendo mar abierto. Ahí vamos ya.
Unos a 20 minutos más vamos a llegar. Oh,
va a haber fiesta ahora en la isla, parece que hay un crucero ahí parado. Hay bastante gente el día de en estos días que va a estar aquí, parece. Si ven ahí ya se van empezando a ver los hoteles.
En ese lado, ahí está lo que viene siendo la playa de la isla, ahí está. Que llegó aquí Va a haber, yo creo, bastante gente en estos días que vamos a estar por aquí.
Llegamos. Aquí estamos. 51 años, 51 años de Clara, ¿eh? Mañana. Sí, cómo no.
Ahí en ese llegamos, mire, nomás. Malecón ya de la isla. Ahí llegamos en ese. Y ahorita nos van a recoger por aquí para llevarnos al hotel. Bastante gente llegó, ¿eh? Aquí está Clara. ¿De qué lado es donde nos van a recoger allá? ¿De qué lado? Clara. Vamos a ir a rentarnos un carrito para ahora domingo irnos para allá para arriba, para el cerro, a conocer desde allá arriba. Esta es una de las calles aquí, hermano. Ahora ahí a Swami, aquí vendimia de cositas aquí. Pabellón. Aquí es donde nos tocó 3 días. Un ratito más vamos a entrar. A las 4 de la tarde nos entregan la suite para quedarnos por aquí, para festejar el cumpleaños de Clara. Mañana 21. aquí en la isla hay puro carrito chiquito, mire, del tamaño de la cumpleañera. Dale, rentese para que se pase en la isla. Feliz cumpleaños, sí, cómo no. Un Morris Cooper. Por aquí estamos el día de hoy, oiga. Unas horas antes de entrar a la festejo de mi esposa Clara, de sus 51, prendieron las alarmas del hotel, del fire, pero parece que todo está bien. Nomás prendieron las alarmas, nada más que gente ya light, nomás en un solo hotel, ¿eh? De Clara, por aquí estamos en la isla Catalina el día de hoy con su Kate. Le voy a llevar su Kate y su pastel. Por aquí estamos en los 51 de Clara. Ya vamos, nos faltan 3 días todavía para de festejo. Un ratito más vamos a ir a comer al restaurante y tenemos un viaje para allá, para ir al aeropuerto, para arriba, para el cerro. Después bajamos y vamos a comer al hotel 51 de Clara. Por aquí estamos en los 51 de Clara, 51 ya, señor. 51 horas, nos venimos a pasear solos. Por acá andamos, de este lado, en la isla Catalina. Sí, como no.
Pecho.
Ya vamos en el elevador, oiga, para arriba. Llegamos. ¿Cómo estamos? Ahorita estamos aquí dentro del hotel. Estamos el día de hoy festejando los 51 años de Clara. Por aquí ya le traje sus florecitas, su pastel, su champagne. Un ratito más y le vamos a brindar aquí. Nos dejaron, los del hotel nos dejaron las copas y el champagne con su agüita, con su tinita de hielo, ¿verdad? Y pues todo está muy bonito aquí, la recámara esta está muy bien. Dormimos bien a gusto anoche, vamos a estar aquí 3 días. En los 51 declara, beso, beso, beso. Al ratito nos vamos a ir a los turns, ya a las 3 sale un turns y luego el otro hasta mañana. Y vamos a ver qué sigue, la cena en la noche.
Sigue el siguiente tour, ahorita a las 3 de la tarde nos van a llevar a conocer todo lo que es la isla, pero por arriba del cerro. Ya cambiaron los camioncitos, ahorita hay puro camión nuevo, ya con pantallas y todo el pedo ahí, ya todo bien. Ya tenemos a las cumpleañeras.
We'll be able to see that in a little while when we get up a little bit higher. We're going to go up about 650 feet above sea level. This Villa Casino Arch, very, very, very familiar. If you all have had any chance to walk down by the water, it's also very popular. You know, our steamships to resort, it used to have a resort type name. And he said, okay, Adame, well, what you got in mind? And she says, well, I'm reading a poem, and it's called Idylls of the King, and it's about King Arthur. And King Arthur had been injured in a battle, and he discovered this little oasis, as he put it, to heal and gain his strength again. And that oasis in a poem?
Utilities, structures, that big, beautiful, long green pier that you see. That
the place
is the
of gathering
pier,
and entertainment. It never meant gambling. The mobsters and all that in Vegas, they had to have a fancier name for gambling, so they adopted the word
called the San Pedro Channel.
Now, the San Pedro Channel is over 3,000 feet deep. It is the deepest saltwater channel.
Nice weather, and look for a dolphin to be jumping alongside the ferry, or the boat, so to speak. We call it the boat because we have a flyer and a ferry.
Yes
to all the above. Yeah, we don't show any more movies there. They stop that in things about the casino. We can we do tours. Okay, we give a tour on Friday, Saturday, and Sunday at the casino. So we have actually a 13-year plan. Well, that was what he wanted. Well, after he put a lot of blood, sweat, tears, time, money, a lot more love into all of it. Stairs to climb up. My husband and I have 47 stairs one way to get to our place.
Good firm.
With gas prices like that. This is why we have so many golf carts here. Here we are. Look at this view. So I'm going to pull up here. I'm going to drive right on the edge of the cliff here. Don't worry. And I'm going to put this in park. You all can stand up, take pictures. Look at our casino from here. That's why we call it the jewel of our town. Now you can see, you know, our harbor is, well, you can kind of see it's in the shape of a crescent moon. Now the Pemungan Indians used to call that harbor
bison,
the bay to the island. And I'm going to bring them to the island. A little heavier on the females. And you know what, Ada? I bet you one day it's going to be a main attraction to the island. And that was 1924. So that's how the bison got here. Well, we have this gorgeous view. What other questions do you have?
The Wrigley home was built in 1921, but that was not the first home built. The first home was the George Chateau that I told you about. But we don't go by that place on this tour.
I like to stop here and let you all enjoy the little town. Can you see the home that has a big, it's a white home with a red roof and it's round?
Which is half?
Down below. It's down below. I can show you a better view of it. The two main buildings that we see in the waterway, the one that's outlined in blue, that's our yacht club. And then the one to the left of it, that's our tuna club. They created, that is the oldest fishing club in the country, and they created that club for bragging rights. And now, the same great home, does everybody see the casino? Okay, the casino, follow it all the way up to the left, and then you'll see Chimes Tower. And that was a gift from Miss Ada Wrigley. That's what you hear chiming in town every so often. And then if you follow it on over to the left again, you see the two white homes, the duplex, if you will. That is where Zane Gray's home was built in 1926. So that's an older structure for you. But now that we have a better view of the home that I told you, right here down below, everybody see now the white home with the red roof, the round porch. There's a swimming pool back there and everything. Everybody see that better now? Okay, that was Peter Gano. And I can stop and you can stand up. Peter Gano, once again, he implemented a lot of the utilities, but he had help building that house. If you ever go to our museum, you'll see that home with nothing else around it. There was no other home around this area back in the day.
Ya vamos para arriba, ya vamos al restaurante a comer la comida pesada de ahorita. Volteate para allá para que salgan las chitas. Vamos aquí de este lado. Pipi.
Aquí es la playita que tiene aquí la isla, miren. Ahorita ya es un poquito tarde, la gente ya se empezó a ir ya para sus hoteles. Vayando uno que otro por ahí bañándose, pero aquí es donde se bañan los que vienen en la playa. Muy limpiecito, lo que sí tiene muchas piedrillas por ahí, pero el agua está muy transparente. Si la miran, y olas pues no hay. No hay olas altas aquí.
Bueno, pues llegó la hora de la cena, de la comida. Ya estamos por aquí. Ahorita nos van a traer unos camarones empanizados, la cara y unos a la diabla para... Feliz cumpleaños en tu 51. Sí. Vamos a cantarle las mañanitas a Clara para que le muerda su pastel. Una, dos, tres. Estas son las mañanitas que cantaba el rey David. A las muchachas bonitas se las cantamos aquí. ¡Que le muerda! ¡Que le muerda! Muérdele recio, ahora ponlo allí para que lo partas. Ponlo ahí para que lo partas.
¿Cómo muérdele recio?
Ahí, de lado, sí, sí. Voltea para acá. Mordida.
¿Ya?
Mordida a la fresa, a la fresa. Muérdele a la fresa, pero allí. Así. Ahí va, una, dos y tres. Ahí está. Bueno, pues ya hoy se está partiendo su pastel de su 51, Clara. Y pues esperamos que nos dure muchos años más. Sí, cómo no. Primeramente Dios, hasta el cielo. Vámonos.
¿Me puedo quitar?
Ya se cambió la cumpleañera.
Good afternoon, how are you guys doing? I'm good, but I have to hear that. You guys are really excited. I can hear that. But the gum, most definitely, right? The gum, that's how he was able to build the field and the he was afford to buy the baseball team, right? So the gum, double mint, spearmint, juicy fruit, the owner of the Chicago Cubs, Wrigley Field. You're right, that's the same guy. So he's the one that purchased this whole island in the year 1919 for approximately $2 million. And that's why I don't answer. I'm not ignoring you. I probably just didn't hear it. I got a loud engine. So I might need the assistance of the people sitting in the front to repeat the questions from the back. Would that be okay? The going through this gate system right here. I'm going to turn a sharp left right here. And then we're going to see the zip line, the first line immediately to the right. Let me get through this gate though. Let me get my key out. So is there anyone zipping across? It's immediately to the right. Do you see the lines? Alright, look at that. Okay, so do you see this road right here on your left? This is the same road we're gonna go out and we're going to come back, return the same way. And at that time, we're going to go through that through that gate again, go with the flow of traffic. I don't know if you know this, but there's a one-way road, like 6 to 8 horses in the front. So whoever purchases these trees, we know by summer it doesn't rain at all. That is just not a good thing. And we're going through a drought right now. My California people on board, you can more, but not as a camper. Really, really pretty. During World War II time, the whole island was closed to the tourism industry, and the only people allowed back were people that lived in Avalon, and all branch of military. Got the Army, Navy, Air Force, Marines. It was a military training ground, any military, right? And then in this specific area, the OSS trained, the Office of Strategic Service, known today as the CIA. Oh my gosh, that's nice. Do you like how I arranged that? Yeah, I kind of frightened him too. he frightened me. I hope he stays there though. Do you like how I arranged that though?
Yeah.
That's actually two guys in a costume. Yeah. I'm just kidding. That's a North American bison. Oh, look at that. He's putting on a show. He's putting a whole bunch of dirt on his beard. So there's the North American bison. We have less than 100 on the island. Oh, look at that. He's doing a wallow bath. You know why he's doing that, right? Because they have fleas. They do have little flies, and that's irritating, right? Sometimes you might see little birds on the back. You know, they have a symbiotic relationship with those birds. Those birds eat the flies and fleas. He's scratching. In the winter time, it's kind of cold in the nighttime, so they tend to grow thick fur at that time. And they know by summertime it gets warm, and today it's warm. And they're trying to shed their fur. April, May, and June, they're scraping against trees and rubbing against the utility poles and what have you. So we have less than 100 on the island. I have the antlers and the deer family, right? The bison family? Both the girls and the boys have the horns. Oh my gosh, look at that. Yeah, he's scratching his head. Is there a log? Or is that a rock?
Go back.
No. Oh, that's a good one right there. Let me back up a little bit. Is that closer? Oh no, that's still the back end. You're seeing the business end of him. He's definitely a boy. Hi, sweetie. No, you just want to be careful. You don't want to. Yeah, you don't want to inadvertently. Oh, he's looking at us. The side of the eye. Oh my gosh, hi. Hi, sweetie. How you doing? My gosh, thank you for clocking in and standing right there for me. Yeah. Oh, so you see all the flies? Oh, he's gonna go right in front of me? Well, that's gonna delay our tour. This is the Catalina traffic. Oh, is he looking? Hi, sweetie, I love you. I love you. He's like, yeah. I can't believe he turned around and looked at us.
I know.
I mean, is that a friendly? We had goat to sheep. We had wild boar. We had, oh, he's peeing. That's a special moment. Are you going to video? Oh, he's laying down and peeing. He's multitasking. See, guys on board, you can sympathize with them, right? Wow, what a good hairstyle. After shaking. over.
Estamos en la pura punta de la isla. Acá es donde está la antena de teléfono, cable y todo ahí arriba.
Mira, para que salga ya el mar.
Por aquí estamos en la punta del cerro de la montaña de la isla. Ya mañana nos vamos, miren nomás, estamos en la orilla sobre donde está el aeropuerto. Si lo miran allá atrásito, allá está el aeropuerto. 51, ¿eh? 51, claro. Ahí está el aeropuerto, en la pura orilla del cerro arriba. El aeropuerto de la isla.
Estoy tomando video.
Ya viene por ahí en ese, nos vamos a ir, iré. Ya va llegando ahorita. A las 10:30 salimos a Harbor y ya de Harbor nos hasta San Pedro. Ya nos vamos, oiga, a la chinga otra vez. Vámonos. Mira más que botones trae este pinche. Ya regresamos. Ahorita vamos a desembarcar, a agarrar nuestro carro y vámonos para casa. Bueno, pues ya tenemos para retirarnos de aquí. Ya estamos ahorita echándonos la última botana. Camarones a la diabla. y los, una librita de empanizados para la cumpleañera. Ya nos vamos
una
a la casa.
Una librita de empanizados y una libra de la diabla aquí ya para retirarnos, oiga. Ya nos vamos. Ándele, chico.
De Stockton, California, DJ Chuy Loco.com.